I'm Michelle Graham, and I'm the choral director at Midlothian High School. And my husband is also a musician. He was the choral director, and we have one daughter, Meredith, who's 26. In December of 2002, I happened to notice a lump under my arm and was not real concerned at first, but later I had it checked out and had actually a mammogram and determined that there was a lump there. Had surgery in December, right before Christmas, and went to see the surgeon and was diagnosed with stage 3 of melanoma, which is skin cancer. I did scans and stuff for several years, and then in 2007, I did a brain scan that showed that the melanoma had metastasized to my brain. And that's when I went to see Dr. Sahni, and he recommended that I have gamma knife surgery.
My name is Singh Sahni, MD, and I'm the chair of the Neuroscience Center. I head the surgical neuro-oncology team here at Johnston-Willis Hospital. Gamma knife is a very highly sophisticated procedure which involves radiation. It's basically cobalt radiation that is used as a very precision-guided method of targeting different parts of the brain. If you have breast, lung, melanomas, or kidney cancer, colon cancer that has metastasized to the brain, we try our level best that as many patients who can get gamma knife, that's their best treatment option.
When you see that brain surgery is neuroscience, and you hear the word surgery, and you hear the word knife, you assume there's going to be some cutting.
People get scared of the word knife. There is no knife involved. That's a misnomer, because these are beams with the precision of a knife. The conventional mode of radiation, which has been done, is where you radiate the entire brain. It has been now quite well documented that that's not a good technique, because the patient gets treated not only just to the tumor, but even the normal brain cells are getting radiation with that. This technique only targets the tumor. So we basically have a patient who comes in at our center, and we fix the head with a special frame, and then the tumor within the brain becomes a fixed target.
And it's pinpoint radiation, so you're measured lots of times by lots of people to make sure they're getting the exact right spot.
That involves medical physicists, radiation oncologists, nurses. So it's a very accurate and involved methodology of taking care of the patient. And once the plan is ready, then the patient is brought to the treatment room right here.
I went in and it was 8 seconds long. And I rolled me right back out and I sat on the side of the bed and they said, "You want to go home?" And I said, "Sure." And that was it. Actually, the next day I got up and went to school after having brain surgery. That's remarkable and life-giving, I think.
It used to be thought by most of my oncology colleagues not long time ago that if you have cancer, a metastasis to the brain, that you have 6 months to live. That is absolutely wrong now. That is not accurate. With the advent of the gamma knife and with the accuracy of the treatment, we have been able to take care of the patients with such metastatic brain tumors for a much longer time.
I think one of the things that cancer patients are often robbed of is everyday life. All of a sudden, you're living a very normal life, and in the next instant, you're in the hospital, you're seeing doctors, you have a million appointments. And so Dr. Sahni pretty much guaranteed me that it would be non-invasive and I could continue teaching right up until the time. I could go right back to teaching. I could go back to being the mom and the wife, you know, all the normal things.
We've had it here at Johnston-Willis Hospital since 2004. We've already done over 3,000 procedures with this, and extremely satisfied with the results, and it really has helped our local community. And we have patients that also come out of city or of the state, and we've been very, very satisfied with the results.
Being in a large metropolitan area where there are lots of doctors available, which I think we're very lucky to have, you soon find out the ones that you trust and that you think are going to take the best care of you possible. And so you seek out those doctors. I don't think you get a doctor as good as Dr. Sahni He's kind, he's compassionate, he's brilliant. He takes time with me, and patients that see him have often life-threatening illnesses. They need someone that's not in a hurry. I can say all that about him. When I first had the Gamma Knife in June of 2007, after that you're scanned pretty regularly to see how the procedure worked. And they can't find any evidence of even where I've had the Gamma Knife. It's disappeared that much. For me, that meant life could go on.